Let me take you to November the 13th of 2007. Do you remember that day?
Yes, kind of, sort of.
Okay. Kind of want to start at the time. Was Mr. Cole living with you on that week, that day?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Did he stay with you the night before on the 12th?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what did y'all do that morning when you got up?
I got up and got ready for work, and he dropped me off at work at 9.
Okay. This is at UMC?
Yes.
Okay. What did you do there?
I was a nursing assistant.
Okay. And so what was your shift?
Well, it varied because I was in school. So that particular day, since I had a short day. It was a 9 to 5, mm-hmm. 9 to 5:30, because I had class at 6.
So, 9 to 5:30?
Yeah, 9 to 5:30.
Okay. Did Mr. Cole come and pick you up?
Yes, he did.
Okay. Was he on time?
I waited for a couple of seconds, maybe a couple of minutes, but he was, pretty much.
It's about 5:35.
Yeah.
Was he with anybody?
Yes, he was with Dante.
Dante Stroud?
Yes.
Did you know Mr. Stroud?
Yeah, from his summer school
roommate. Okay, so they were friends and you just knew him through that?
Yes.
Okay. What did y'all do then?
I had to go to class at 6 o'clock, so they stopped by the gas station, mm-hmm. and then they took me to class.
Did they buy anything at the gas station?
Some gas.
Just gas?
That's all I can remember. Okay. Gas.
And then they were taking you to JSU to class?
Yes, JSU.
What time did your class start again?
6.
Okay. And then what happened next?
Well, class was canceled, so we had to go get our assignment for the rest of the semester from the dean's office. Mm-hmm. And I called him back to come pick me up, and he told me to meet him between liberal arts and the CFO walkway.
Okay. So about what time did he get there?
I can't. Maybe about 6:10, 6:15.
Okay. Well, where'd y'all go then?
Then Dante said he wanted to take us all out to eat. We're going to double date. So he took me home. So I changed clothes. And
all the way out on Ridgewood Road?
All the way out on Ridgewood Road.
Okay. So you changed clothes?
Yes, to bed. Yeah,
because you're wearing scrubs, I assume, working at UMC?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you changed clothes. Did Mr. Cole and Dante stay there while you changed?
Well, they both came in with me. Mm-hmm. When I got to the tub at the shower, put my clothes on, came back into the front room. Dante was the only one there.
Okay.
He was gone.
He was gone?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
What time did he come back to pick you up?
I can't remember. It's like 7 or something.
Okay. Where'd y'all go then?
Then we had to go pick up Dante's girlfriend back from the school because she had a meeting, so we didn't get her when we first left the school. She had that meeting, so we were back to Jackson State.
So you went back, she lived on campus?
Yeah, she lived on campus.
And that's Jakeisha Rule?
Yes.
Okay, so y'all drove from Ridgewood Road back to Jackson State?
Yes.
Okay, where'd you go next?
Then we went to, I won a buffet, so we went to Golden Career.
And that's all the way down Lakeland Drive?
Lakeland Drive.
Okay. And what happened then?
They was through service, so we was like, well, we go down the street to Ryan's. Mm-hmm. Ryan's closed, and we went to, like, I think it's Sicily's mm-hmm. Pizza. We went there, they was closed, so we just finally went to Garfield's.
Okay, and y'all came back up Lakeland Drive to the interstate?
Came back up Lakeland Drive.
On that route, is there any hospitals on Lakeland Drive that you know of?
Other than UMC, on down past the intersection.
And River Oaks on Lakeland
Drive? Oh, yeah, River Oaks.
Okay. And then y'all took I-55 North to Caroline Road?
Yes.
Okay. And y'all ate at Garfield's?
Did we what?
Y'all ate at Garfield's?
Yeah, we ate at Garfield's.
Okay. Do you remember what you had?
Shrimp Alfredo.
Okay, that's a good memory.
I just love pasta.
How was Mr. Cole acting?
I don't know. He was acting all right to me. Everybody, when we first walked in Garfield's, I sat down because I was dehydrated, so I got me a glass of water. And they all went to wash their hands or whatever. Mm-hmm. So, we waited on, everybody came back and sat down, and then Stanley had to go outside. So we waited on him. It got maybe 3 or 4 minutes, and we just constantly waited so we could order our drinks and food. So I was headed towards to go see where he was, and he walked in the door, so.
About what time was this that you're all eating there? Around 8:30, 9 o'clock, maybe?
Yeah, around that time, about 8 something, because everybody else was closed, so it was about 8, between 8 and 9.
Okay. Do you remember if there was much people in the restaurant?
No, I can't remember.
Okay. And after y'all got done eating, what'd you do next?
We got through eating. We had to take Jaquisha back to school.
Okay, so you drove all the way back to Jackson State?
All the way back to Jackson State.
Okay. And then what happened after that?
Then Dante, he wanted to go get him a little dagger knife. Mm-hmm. So we took him to Walmart.
Okay, which Walmart?
I think it was on 18.
Okay, so you drove from Jackson State to the closest Walmart, which is on Highway 18.
Yes.
Okay. Well, after y'all were in Walmart shopping, where'd you go after that?
We dropped Dante back off at the Palisades. That's the apartment he stayed in by Jackson State.
Okay, and then y'all went back to your apartment?
Yeah, he dropped me back off at my apartment.
Did he stay there?
He came in with me, mm-hmm. then he went back out to empty the trash.
Okay. When's the next time you saw him?
Well, after he entered the trash, he came back into the room, and he said, he said he'd be right back. Mm-hmm. And he left back out. So, I thought he maybe went over his cousin's Tony house because he said he'd be right back. And he had previously said that he was over Tony's house earlier in between the time we had, we get ready to go pick up Jaquisha.
Mm-hmm.
So, I called him maybe about, I was at home maybe about 11:30, and I called him maybe 20, 30 minutes after and asked him where he at. Where are you?
Where did he say he was?
He didn't answer the phone.
Oh, he answered, okay.
He didn't answer the phone for a couple of minutes, and then he finally called me back, said he's on his way back home.
Okay, what time did he get home?
About 1 something.
About 1 in the morning?
Mm-hmm.
What was his appearance when he got there?
Came back in, and he had like little strips of blood on his shirt, like a little nosebleed right there.
Like a nosebleed?
Yeah.
Okay. What did y'all do? Did y'all just go to bed then?
I asked him, what is that on your shirt? What is that blood on your shirt? Mm-hmm. And he was like, yeah, me and Tony, we got in a fight with the upstairs neighbors because they had playing too much music. And Tony's fiance was trying to get some sleep because she was pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
And they was giving up too much noise. And they was, went up the stairs to talk to him, but I guess whoever was up there was getting talking crazy, so they got the fight.
Okay, so that's what he said happened. He was in a fight at Tony's place.
Yeah.
And Tony lived over at the Trace, didn't he? Originally?
Yeah, that's his name, yeah. Right, not too far from the mall.
Okay. Well, what happened the next day?
We got up. I had class at 8, so he asked me, he said that the, advisor had told him to get his girlfriend to withdraw him from school, which I thought was me. So I withdrew him from school, and then I went to class. Where Sade called me on my way to my 11 o'clock class and told me, asked me, have you seen Stanley? I was like, yeah, he just dropped me out. She was like, I said, is everything okay? She was like, something's wrong. And she was like, what she said? She'll call me back. She'll call and talk to me later. And I was like, okay. And I called him, and I said, call Sade. I don't know what's going on, but something's going on. She said, something's wrong. Please call and see what's going on.
Okay. And did you ever get in contact with Mr. Cole that day?
Yeah.
Okay. Was that the day that Latasha Norman was reported missing?
Yeah, that was the same day.
Okay. Did he say anything about it to you that day?
No.
Nothing. Did you, didn't y'all eventually go to Greenville together?
We went that Monday.
That Monday?
Mm-hmm.
Did he ever make any statement whether he did it or not to you?
No.
No, he didn't say. Okay. Did you ever ask him?
I asked him once, and he said, I asked him, had he seen Tasha?
Mm-hmm.
He said no.
He said he hadn't seen her. Okay. Mm-hmm. And this whole time, you know, you guys have been dating on and off, and in this period of November the 13th of 2007, you were 2 months pregnant.
Yes, I was.
And with his child?
Yes, I was.
Okay.